apparatus required. This is ultrasonic interference device with water, and this is the measuring setup. By using this setup, we are going to determine the velocity and then compressibility. Before starting the experiment, proper gain should be given, and then the adjuster also properly adjusted. The probe is connected with two ends properly. The interference part, the rod is connected with the micrometer screw. In that micrometer screw, it has two scales. One is pitch scale that exists vertically, and then another one, the rod is head scale coincidence. The rod is existing in the cylindrical disc. Before starting the experiment, the micrometer screw also adjusted properly. That means the pitch scale 0 is made to coincide with the head scale coincidence of 0. And then proper adjustment, it should be adjusted in order to keep the needle at any position except the end positions. Now we have to switch on the ultrasonic interferometer, and then gain should be properly given. Adjuster also adjusted to keep the needle at any position. At the same instant, the ultrasonic sound waves, which are produced by the ultrasonic piezoelectric crystal, these waves which are sent through the liquid that exists in the interference part, and then one part of the sound waves that is reflected by the upper surface of the disc, and then these waves which are produced stationary waves, these stationary waves that is also called as standing waves, and the liquid that is called as acoustical grating. At this position, we have to adjust the micrometer screw by adjusting the needle, the top waves. By adjusting the micrometer screw, we have to make 5 oscillations. With respect to that, we have to measure the pitch scale and the head scale readings. In this manner, for each and every 5 oscillations, we have to note down the pitch scale and the head scale coincidence readings up to 50 oscillations. The wavelength can be determined by using the tabulation, and then the velocity of ultrasonic sound waves can be determined by using the formula V is equal to nu lambda, where nu is the frequency of ultrasonic sound waves, that is 2 megahertz of frequency, and then the compressibility of the given liquid K, that is equal to 1 by V square into rho, where rho is the density of the given liquid and V is the velocity of ultrasonic sound waves.